What's up, everyone, and once again, welcome back to Super Smash Bros. For Wii U All-Star Mode. Last time, we took it on as Greninja and finished up the third row of characters, and this time, we're heading in, once again, as Rob. Now, back in Smash 3DS, the palettes we used were, of course, the Famicom Rob. We also used the, like, camo kind of looking Rob, and we used this Virtual Boy-looking Rob. So, I think for this episode, I am gonna go with... It's a toss-up between purple and gold, or yellow. I think I'm gonna go with this one, though. I like all the yellow and gold palettes characters get, so let's go with this one. It's kind of like a gold-plated Rob. Imagine getting a Rob, like the one that actually works with the NES, and it's like a gold-plated one. That'd be neat. Also, hell of a good song to get right here. I love this one. And also, Rob's side B is probably gonna come in handy here, especially on walk-off stages. Because its horizontal knockback is pretty damn good. Although these guys seem to be breaking out of it a lot, so maybe not. Yeah, this... God, this, what the hell am I trying to say? This song that's playing right now? Ooh, that could work too. This song that's playing, I believe I used this back when Super Mario Galaxy 2 Versus was a thing on this channel. Which, if you haven't seen that, it is a very old series I did with my friend Billy. And I'm fairly certain in the trailer I use this music, and it's of course from Galaxy 2, so that's why I did that, but yeah, it's taken me back. It is definitely taken me back. That beam did not go where I wanted it to, but okay. Let's try the side B again. Yeah, they're breaking out of it. That's kind of annoying. One more maybe? Okay, one more maybe? Yeah, okay, that's not working as well as I planned, so maybe down smash, because that also sends horizontally like that. But it sends horizontally based on the side they get hit on, so I probably should try to actually hit on the correct side. Yeah. Rosalina, oh no, Luma's out, but Rosalina's still here. There we go, and Bayonetta. He just yeeted her off the stage. I love when you do side B in the slow motion, how like low the frame rate looks. It's so odd. 47 damage after the first fight. I think we'll be okay for the second one. I think we'll be okay. Rob's decent. Rob is definitely decent. He's not the best character in the game, obviously. He's not Bayonetta, but he's still good. I know my friend Isaac, he mained him. I think he mains him in Ultimate. Maybe that's where the side B's better, and that's what I'm thinking of. But he did or does main him, and he kicked my butt with him. And also, oh my god, I'm proud of that kill. He's fun. He's definitely better than he was in Brawl. I'll give him that. Well, in my opinion, anyway. I never really played him in Brawl that much, so maybe I'm not really one to talk. But he's good. It's more evidence to the fact that Sakurai can literally make a character out of anybody. Like, make a fighter out of anybody. Of course, he did it with Piranha Plant in Ultimate. In this game, he did it with Rob. He did it with Mr. Game & Watch. He's done it with the Ice Climbers. He can make a moveset out of nothing, and I love him for that. He's a great dude. Very talented man, Mr. Sakurai. And I guess going on from that, we'll make that our comment question. Out of all of the kind of obscure, I guess, retro and random characters that they added in, which one's your favorite? And this is across all Smash games, so I'm including, like, Rob, the Ice Climbers, Mr. Game & Watch, Duck Hunt, Piranha Plant, of course. Any of the weird, obscure, retro ones like that? Who's your favorite? My personal favorite, I'm not even gonna lie, is Piranha Plant. I love that dude, and I'm so glad he's in Smash. I think he's not gonna make it back for the next one, if they do another one, but I would not complain if he was back for the next Smash game, because he's unique, he's obscure, he's just the weirdest, most random addition, but he's fun. And he's not, I mean, people say he's bad, tier lists say he's bad. I don't think he's the worst character in the game, I think he's alright. But yeah, that's him for me, that's the one for me, that's the character I think for that question. So you let me know yours in the comment section below. Definitely got a few comments, I was asking about mains I think in the last episode, and I definitely got a few responses to that. I saw a lot of people posting their mains, and I know, I think it was Crazy Good, I believe he posted Lucario? Dude, my dude, if you're watching, is Lucario really your main in Ultimate? I thought it was, like, Captain Falcon, but I guess maybe I'm thinking of somebody else. But fair enough, if Lucario's your main, I guess you probably got a little upset then when I was talking about how how Lucario's moves just feel weird to me, feel like they don't work right. Or you just didn't care because you're a normal human being, but you get my point. I think. Maybe you get my point. I don't know. Let me know in the comments, Daniel. Anyway, I want to finish someone off with a laser beam, but I don't think it's going to happen. Okay, let's try and get a dunk here. Ugh, that'll do. That is a dunk. Have a down smash and have... Yeah, no, that's not going to work. I jumped at the wrong time. Yeet! That didn't work either. No. Damn it, I could have definitely hit him right there. Oh, is that going to... Oh, that's going to do it. Okay. That is one way to take down a Diddy Kong, let me tell you. Let me take a drink, because my throat is getting sore. Ugh, by God, do I love coffee. And that is a nice trophy to get. It's Toad on the Quacker. Throwback to Mario Kart Wii. I want to play that game again. I mean, I did a live stream series on it. I played through the entire game over on Twitch. And if you actually want to watch that, there's videos up on my Thomas J. Live channel, which should be linked in the description. It should say VOD Archive. And then next to it is the link to that. And that's where you can find all of those. So if you want to watch me play through Mario Kart Wii for a second time, 100%, because of course I've got a 100% Let's Play on this channel as well, then you can do that. And it was a lot of fun. It was fun to go back to. But just seeing Toad on the Quacker right there kind of made me want to go back and play it again. So, hey, Mario Kart Wii custom tracks, anyone? Maybe? I don't know. Talk about that at a different... Probably a different time, because I've got stuff planned out for a good chunk of the rest of this year. But hey, if we all get quarantined, guess what? I'm gonna have more time to record, so maybe we will get time to play some other games. I really hope that doesn't happen. Like, I like being home, but I like my friends, and I like to leave the house, so let's hope that that doesn't happen. Hashtag, thanks, coronavirus. I don't know what I'm saying anymore, but... Yeah, whatever. Hopefully that doesn't happen, and I hope I'm not getting sick. But I guess we will see. Here we go! Yoshi! 27, 27! Actually, that was 37 on Doc. I have literally just stood here and done forward smash, and it's working. Why? Why? I'm gonna get hit by the building, okay. Well, it worked for the most part until the building decided to show up. Doc? There we go. That is the first three gone, and all I did was stand there and forward smash and then do a couple up smashes. But hey, if it works, it works, right? If it works, it works. I am getting my butt kicked just slightly. I'd like to not have that happen. That was because of the F-Zero machines, and I knew that was gonna happen. Let me tell you, we're four matches in, and I've already had to use two healing items, one of which was the fairy bottle. We were at 90%, three matches left, I need to use this. This is not going well on this second run, I am not even gonna lie. That first run was much better. So, I've either just not been playing it safe enough, or I just got really lucky the first time through. Or both. Who knows? Also, Doc, you were supposed to stay on that platform! Luckily, we got this stage and not Port Town Aero Dive again, because Port Town definitely is what screwed us over that time. You know, because we only died to the stage. It feels like any time I die in one of these runs, it's never to an enemy. It's always just to the stage or to me falling off or something similar, you know? I never die to someone just getting a nice hit on me. Like, in the Greninja run, we died in that one, but not because anyone killed us, just because we got slightly pushed back and I down-aired off the stage. I'm fairly certain that I looked back on it. I think we only got pushed back because we were being pushed by Yellow Devil anyway. And the momentum followed me, applied to me while I was going into the air. So it caused us to move back while I was jumping up and I didn't notice and I did the down air. But hey, we're doing a little bit better in this version of this fight. I'll say that much. If Mega Man could stop shooting me with his lemons, that'd be great. Ryu's somehow still here. I feel like he's been here forever. Get off the stage. Oh, there we go. I almost ran right off. And of course, Mega Man's still here. Yeet! Okay, 14%. That I'm not too worried about. We can go into the second fight, take as much damage as we need to. Or second to last fight, I mean. And then use the final heart container before the last one. And this is the fight that has Rob in it. So here we go. See how we do. What stage are we gonna get? Mushroomy Kingdom? No. Is Mushroomy Kingdom in this game? Yeah, I think it is. They put the top half of Mushroomy Kingdom in here. They didn't bring back the... Or did they bring back the underground area of Mushroomy Kingdom in this game? Or is that in Ultimate where they cut that? I honestly can't remember. I honestly cannot remember anything about Mushroomy Kingdom. But I don't exactly play on Mushroomy Kingdom all that often, so that's probably why. Down smash. Now, in Ultimate, Rob's down throw actually buries opponents, so it's a hell of a lot better. I mean, it's still decent in this game. I'm fairly certain it combos into up air. At least I think it does. I feel like I've been using that. Okay, stop it. I know I picked up your wife or whatever, Bowser, but... doesn't mean you need to punch me. It's just rude. Go away. Have a neutral air. I love Rob's neutral air, because... I just love neutral airs that are overly powerful for, like, seemingly no reason. Because this guy just, like... Yeah, it doesn't look like it'll be powerful, but it sure as hell is. Like, just for no reason. I want to try that down throw thing I talked about. Down throw. Up air. Well, at least on CPUs it seems to work. Twice. I don't know if that would work on, like, actual human players, but... hey, it worked on those two. And I didn't even see what damage we got to. I feel like it wasn't much. I don't think we got hit that much. 32! Alright, so the last three fights, then, have been, kind of my saving grace for this run. Because I did not do good. Also, I got Pokemon Stadium 2 for, the fight with, like, Ganondorf and the old, like, four Pokemon or whatever. I feel like we rarely get that stage. It also didn't transform, I don't think. I legitimately can't remember. My mind has just gone blank. But, yeah, I guess they don't have stage transformations in All-Star, and I just didn't remember that. Again, because of how many breaks I've taken in this series, I kind of forget the details, but... hey, at least we're back and being consistent now. Could you stop punching me, little Mac? Mr. Wireframe Mac, you need to go away. I kind of just want to get rid of Mac. Oh, is that going to do it? Yes, that's going to do it. Alright, right as he got his KO punch, too. Okay, side B for you guys. Gonna connect with the final hit on Mario. Definitely feel like that was buffed in the next game. I'm glad that we can hit through ceilings. That is helpful. Not glad for that. Oh, no! You are goddamn kidding me. Oh my god, seriously? In the last match? Oh, if that isn't just the most beautiful way to kill a little Mac. My god, welcome back. It has been another like 10 minutes because that's how long this thing takes. I have just been getting gimmicked. Like, I'm getting gimmicked so hard. I mean, the first time we died because of the Port Town Aerodive F-Zero machines, and that second time we died because we got pushed off the stage by the fire hydrant. And then I was already doing, like, a neutral aerial, I think, and that just caused us to not be able to do the up B, and then we died. So, yeah. Bit of a better run through this time, though. Didn't have to use the fairy bottle, which is nice, and I was also only at, like... okay, we're up there now. I was only at, like, 20 damage before this fight, and then I used the last heart container for that, so... there we go! Much better run. Rob, I am sorry that we caused you to die twice. We're half an hour into this recording, but it is done. 7 minutes 51. I gotta say, he does not look very comfortable in that final smash. He looks like his neck is broken, if I'm being honest with you. But there we go, another run in the bag. It took 3 attempts, but hey, at least we're done. And don't forget, you guys, comment question of the day. The whole thing regarding the, regarding which obscure, retro, or just weird character is your favorite across all of Smash Brothers. And if there's any that I didn't mention, feel free to mention them as well. You could, maybe you have a different definition of what an obscure or weird or retro character is. So, definitely let me know. Also, this is adorable. Don't you ever talk to my son, to me or my son, ever again, is exactly what this victory screen is, what this end poster picture thingy is. This game has destroyed my brain and now I can't speak. Oh, this run has destroyed my brain and now I can't speak. Also, I just want to appreciate... giant spinning Rob, because when he does his When he does the screw attack jump, he just rotates horizontally as opposed to like going in a vertical spin like everybody else does. And I just think that's really neat. I guess they didn't want to have him spin around like a regular person or something? I don't know. Also, give me this. I believe everything we need. I love his little dance there. I believe everything we need to fill in is at the bottom. We're at 98.99%. Yeah, I love when he gets the mushroom and he does his little, like, hands on his hips kind of spin thing. That was adorable. I love that little detail. Come on. Just need the picture to go all the way back up. I'm just gonna keep on spinning. I think we got some stuff over this side, maybe. But there's literally nothing. Okay, right over here. 99% exactly right now. Okay, now is it just this? I believe it is just this bit. There we go. 100%. So we had a pretty unsuccessful couple of runs right there. But the third one brought it back. And we also got 100% in the credits game. So Rob, you did good, buddy. You did all right. 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. Sora appears quicker than I remember it does. I like the little detail that in his victory screen, he's actually in the Japan, or the Famicom alt, because that is, of course, the standard one in the Japanese version of the game. In this game, he starts off, his first palette is the NES one. But yeah, in the Japanese one, it's, of course, the Famicom one, so it's kind of interesting that they didn't change that in the victory video. Also, he really only gets 3 trophies? I feel bad for this dude. Super Diffusion Beam. For Rob's final smash, he folds his arms down, transforms into an invincible cannon, and fires a huge beam that can be panned slowly up and down. The beam splits up partway through into smaller beams that drag foes to the center, where they'll be hit continuously. The assault finishes off with a single wide beam just for good measure. He destroys people. And the trophy box is Final Smashes 3. We haven't been back to just a regular Final Smashes trophy box in a while. But there you go. He's alongside. Oh, he's there in the back, actually. Nope, that's Samus. Where's he at? He's in the back left. With Samus and Olimar, and then, of course, Zero Suit Samus, Ness, and Luigi in the front there. And his other trophy, Rob Alt. Rob's side smash, S3, fires a laser beam that does more damage up close. You can also aim it slightly up or down before firing. His down special gyro sends, gyro, sends a spinning top hurtling forward and can be charged for more damage. You can even dodge while charging. Appears in the Nintendo Entertainment System Robotic Operating Buddy for the NES. And then for some reason they kept this tech squished, but Mario Kart DS on the DS. I don't know why do they have Mario Kart DS squished like that? It will fit in there. Anyway. With that, folks, 35 minutes into this recording, we are done with Rob's run. Next time, we're heading back into All-Star, and we will be taking it on as Ness. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like, and of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.